It's see? Quite something. It's so cute. That is a chipmunk over there. He just met. So cute.
Can you see him? Did you zoom in?
Yeah. This one's eating too. This one's just so cute. He's looking here.
So fast!
Rina and Kesha's house.
Please.
I don't want to cooperate.
I would say, we saw an example just a few weeks ago when you had the Attorney General and the FBI Director announcing a heightened security environment.
We have this with zero fat. Zero fat mango. Come on. Your whatever diet is, it should be large.
I brought more.
Seriously.
How could I have a
see, she wants to always ride on my back. She wants to have a chocolate, so she's doing it. I brought some more.
Okay, so Mr. Kesha, so how long have you had your ice cream parlor running in this hotel?
What?
So how long have you had this?
The pleasure of our guests.
Oh yeah.
I just
we have the pleasure of our guests to watch you.
You don't actually like ice cream yourself.
I just take it because it pleases the guests.
You know, there was once Charles when she was in
it. It pleases the guests. I don't particularly want to eat it myself.
But it pleases the guests, so
but
I have
to
do it.
It makes the guests happy. So, what are you saying about Charles?
Charles stayed here with us for a year when she went, no, half a year actually, when she went to school in New York. So, the first time he took the ice cream out and offered it, Chad said, I don't eat ice cream. He said, no, he was shocked. He said, it looks like you like
no,
ice cream.
No, I said, but it looks like you like it. Because she was nice and chubby and gory chitty.
Oh, she got so upset. She stamped out and walked out and she was like, that was so rude! How could you have said that? What do you mean? It looks like I like ice cream. And they didn't talk for a while, and then after that they started joking about it. So then he started, everything, it was like, looks like you like this. It looks like...
But I hate him because he said, Tara, you look like you're fond of your food. I'm just like, okay. Tara's very fond of her food.
Okay, good. Thank you so much, Sherry. Bye-bye.
Put my bag.
Billy, come here. Oh, Billy's come. Cash. Cash. I'm going to stop on my way back and I'll go buy tea. So you are down and just
Kelly's. Click on white. This is the little road. This is the Rye Cemetery. I'm actually trying to find the Rye Shopping Centre. I don't think these people will be doing it. This is Rye Beach, the one that you pay for to go on. people are just looking for coins. Park directly behind the beach. It's free. Long Island I'm looking at across the water there.
Hi.
Hello. Guy, they got a commission to make for the CEO of PepsiCo. They made 80 plates that she then did an image of her eagle on it as giveaways. He gave them for Christmas presents or Happy New Year presents, corporate gifts, you know. It was such a nice order. Pepsi Cola,
yeah. Mm. Parent company is called PepsiCo.
pose for company. Pepsi company. Pepsi Cola, whatever.
Capricorn.
They're good.
Did I move the grass?
Yeah. Ronaldo Pomodoro.
But see, I think the ones up there, doesn't that look like...
That looks like Giacometti.
Giacometti,
exactly. Such a beautiful view.
Who is it? Ah, you were right.
It's spelled Du Buffet. Du Buffet.
Yeah.
John Du Buffet. You ask love, indeed. It's all stone sculpture, mm-hmm. Right? With paint on it.
Yeah.
Painted polyester resin.
Order,
yeah. The right thing.
Yeah. I love these trees, they look like snow.
These are called blue spruces.
They're beautiful, aren't they?
Yeah.
Just.
Oh, it's such a lovely place, isn't it?
Oh, this is so nice. I can see this from here now.
Oh, it looks so nice from here. That really fits.
Dogwood tree. They're everywhere. Flowers are beautiful. They sit above the leaves.
You know, when it's a nice day, you're allowed to come and picnic here and all. They're so good about letting you use the space.
Yeah.
Here.
It doesn't look like ginkgo, almost like a ginkgo, but it isn't the leaf of it.
Maybe it is a Japanese.
They have beautiful specimens.
Katsura, that's what it is. These are katsuras. Beautiful. Japan and China. Just look how artistic they are. Look at the branches.
Now the ginkgo tree is also really interesting to look at. But this katura. Yeah, they're all katuras. Beautiful. The delicateness of them. There's something unusual about it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Look at the big fat branch there. They're going right up. Look at it. And it shoots there. So incredible. The whole stem of it. That's what it is.
No, it's not. Yeah, the concrete's not very well worn, is it? I haven't got the plaque up yet. Colors.
Look at where these trees are growing. It's almost because of the sunlight, they're not growing on the inside.
Yeah.
Just one-sided. They've lost all the branches. You want me to go see who did that? Or you want to come there?
Because it looks like it's going to have
a lot. Might not be written. It might be just lights. That's all wooden. They're beautiful in the night. They light
gorgeous.
Them up.
Oh, right.
Incredible. Actually, the front is this side. You see, they're all lights. I
think it was a bit of a
scale's very interesting.
I'll get up.
Yeah.
They just carved them out of the hole.
Oh,
yeah.
An
life.
I think I just don't like the composition here with these angle bars.
Cube totem 7 and 6. David Smith. This is our Brett Price.
Mm-hmm.
Is it Brett,
the
big scoop. Big scoop.
Big scoop of the hole. Now that inside, the artwork must be. Yes. It must have plenty of painting too. Look at it.
Beautiful.
Really fun. Japanese towering cherry from Mount Fuji. This is a lot of money spent to lay this
yes.
out.
There's Miro.
What's her name? Joan Miro.
Yeah.
Juan Miro. Or Joan. How do you say it? So beautiful.
He's quite cute.
Oh, the lavender one. It's probably their AC.
Okay.
It's their cooling. Oh. And their heating units. There's so much on other side.
Yeah.
We can, you know, the thing is, we have to walk everything. We can't park anywhere else. But if I take you there, it will just like
a mad.
Oops. Watch the gate.
Yeah.
Watch
okay.
the gate.
Okay. Will you put it up when I go, or it will go up itself when I go close? Oh, you're doing it. Thank you.
Train trip up to Boston. Sort of marshy lands. What a misty, foggy day today. It'll be clear up as the day goes on.
Yeah, the next station stop will be New London. Thank you.
Quincy Markets. It's huge, big indoor and outdoor markets. The one that says Quincy Market, the building in the middle, is a huge food hall. Every imaginable food.
That will give you gas. Hop!
I'll do that later. Hop, hop! Warm-up trick number one. There we go.
Hop!
Oh yeah.
Metal A-frame on my face. Then, sir, with the dog, will you take your hands out of your pockets and clap this time? We have an oral agreement. Okay, good, because I have a lawyer. Buddy, if I can do this, give me a big cheer, we'll start the show. Hop!
Hop!
Ooh, danger. Thank you for getting my sense of humor. I want to have some fun today.
A little park just next to Stephanie and Peter's house. Okay. This is the apartment they live in. They haven't used for the swimming pool. And they're a little in five. this one? Looking at the outside the lounge window. That's the building I'm staying in, right on the water. It's a little bit like downtown Auckland. Right on the marina. Prescott. Is it the foot of the bunker hill in the beginning? Following the Freedom Trail, starts off with a brick road, or brick line at least. It's 3 miles long, takes in most of the city. I'm still in Boston, walking the full Freedom Trail, which goes for 3 miles. It's a bit of a gruesome one. Stones are just kind of just stuck there, so they haven't all fallen over. It's very thin slabs shoved into the ground. Hill burying ground, stroll among the graves, lean on the freestone slab which lies over the bones of the Mathers. Read the epitaph of stout William Clark, this advisor of sorry persons and little actions. Stand by the stone grave of sturdy Daniel Malcolm and look upon the splintered slab that tells the old rebel stories. Dr. Oliver Wendell Holmes, professor at the breakfast table, 1859.
Thank you. thought that it was just going to fit.
Yeah.
And
Old North Church. There's a little plaques all around this little courtyard telling little stories. It's the old North Church. The lanterns of Paul Revere are hanging in that church. Little Italy, the Italian quarter, it's mostly restaurants. In the Italian quarter of the North End. So glass sculptures in the Paul Revere courtyard.
We took the tour.